If you have never worked with a USB flash drive, you will probably want to watch this. First of all, let's just look at the type of connector shown here. Locate the ports on your computer. Notice the horizontal bars in the ports and on the end of the flash drive. The ones on the ports shown here are white. Sometimes they are red or black, as shown on this flash drive. Align the horizontal bar in the flash drive connector with the empty space in the USB port. If it feels like you are going to have to force it, turn the drive over. The bars may be misaligned. It should plug in snugly, but you should not have to apply excessive force. Try connecting the flash drive now if you haven't already. After plugging in the drive, it may take it a few moments to become available. Oftentimes, a driver has to be installed for the flash drive to work. In this demo, Auto Run is enabled, so it opened a window showing the contents of the drive. Yours may not do that. If not, open the Start menu. Type in This PC. Click on it. Right-click on the flash drive. Click Rename. Type in your name or as much of it as you can. Press Enter. Double-click the flash drive to access it. You continue double-clicking through folders until you find the one you are looking for. Now let's take a look at how to save a file. Click Start. Type in Excel. Click it. Open a blank workbook. Enter a few simple numbers. Click File, Save As, This PC, Browse. Scroll on the left to find This PC. Click on the flash drive. Create a new folder if desired by clicking New Folder at the top of the Save As window. Enter a folder name. Press Enter. Double-click the folder. Enter a file name. File names are often provided in assignment instructions. Click Save. It's very important to close files when you are finished working on them. Click the X in the upper right corner of the Excel window to close the file. It's also very important to close files before removing the flash drive from the computer. To eject the flash drive, click the Show Hidden Icons button in the system tray if necessary. Click on the Safely Remove Hardware icon. Click on Eject for the flash drive. Always do this before removing the drive from the USB port. If you don't, data corruption can occur if the computer is still using a file or two temporarily. That sometimes happens. There are lots of processes running behind the scenes that we as users do not see. If it still won't let you safely remove it, you can log the computer off or shut it down before removing the drive.